Hope everyone is online. So we'll start our class today. See, till the last week we have done organic chemistry. Already I told you the basic very important concepts of organic chemistry I have done. Okay. Now let us come to the next important part, inorganic chemistry, coordination chemistry. Shall we start? Everyone is ready there, right? Now let us see what is coordination chemistry. This is the next important objective coming from inorganic concept, and here we are coming across nearly two objective in NEET examination. So let us see the main concepts. Yes, let us see the main concepts which are coming in coordination chemistry. Okay, so the first type of question is the types of ligands. Now let us start the coordination compound, and from there how the questionnaires will come from different concepts, let us see. Okay, so now see, say I am taking a double salt KCl MgCl2 6H2O. This is called as what? Double salt. So why it is called as double salt? Listen, okay, so why it is called as double salt? Whenever we are dissolving in water, it gives K plus Cl minus Mg plus 2. So the double salt loses its identity in aqueous solution, so that is called as double salt. The same hand, if I am taking a complex compound K4FeCN taken 6 times. So when you are dissolving in water, it gives 4K plus and FeCN taken 6 times minus 4. So it is a complex ion. On dissolving in water, the complex ion again it will not give into different ions, means ionization will not be taking place in complex ion. So such type of compounds are called as what? Complex compounds. They are also known as what? Coordination compounds. Why? There is a coordinate covalent bond between the ligand and central metal atom. That's why it is also known as coordination chemistry. So our main interest is to study about the coordination chemistry, their shape, geometry and the energies, how they are going to stabilize. So in that, let us come particularly for complex compound. So I am taking this. According to Werner theory only we will explain. So according to Werner theory, we are having two chambers or two spheres in a complex compound. What are they? One is ionization sphere. So this is formed by ionic bond. So we are having what? 4K plus and FeCN taken 6 times minus 4. This particular species is called as what? Coordination sphere. There only the coordinate covalent bond formation takes place between the central metal atom and the ligands. So this sphere is called as what? Coordination number. Sorry, coordination sphere. In coordination sphere, we are having central metal atom surrounded by a certain group of species. They are called as what? Ligands. So central metal atom is surrounded by certain species. They are called as what? Ligands. Ligands may be electron rich species or more like nucleophiles. They also can be having negative charge. They are ready to donate the electrons to the central metal atom. They are called as what? Ligands. The number of ligands that surrounds central metal atom is called as what? Coordination number. So the central metal atom with how many species it is coordinating, that is called as what? Coordination number. In this case, CN, 6 CN ligands are surrounding Fe. So how many number of, what is the coordination number of central metal atom? 6. So that is the number of ligands that surround central metal atom is called as coordination number. Now, the first kind of objective comes is types of ligands. So, here you may be expecting one objective. So, what is type of ligands? We are having many type of ligands. First one is monodentate. For example, if a ligand is donating one lone pair electron, that is called as what? Monodentate ligand. If it is donating two, bidentate. If it is more than three, they are called as what? Polydentate ligand. So these are simple. Next is chelate ligands. For example, EDTA. Ethylene diamine trichloroacetic acid, EDTA. So in this is a chelating ligand. What is chelating ligand? From different sides, it is originating the central metal atom. So that is called as what? Chelate ligand. Chelate ligand will have more than one donation sites. All the donation sites are coordinating to what? Central metal atom. That is called as what? Chelating ligand. The another kind of ligands are bridge ligands. For example, a complex is there like this, NH3, COOH, EN taken twice. This is a complex. Here ammonia and OH are coordinating with Cr and CO. They are donating electron pairs to both the metal atoms. So such type of ligands are called as what? Bridge ligands. So depending upon their the donation, how, whether they are donating one, two, or from different sites. For example, ambidentate, CNNC. The electrons can come, CN minus, from carbon the electrons can come. In NC, the lone pair on nitrogen can donate. So these are called as what? Ambidentate ligands. What are ambidentate ligands? Ligand is monodentate only, but it is having two sites. From any of the corner, it may attach to the central metal atom. So such type of ligands are called as what? Ambidentate. Basically, they are monodentate, but the sites, more than one site will be present. From which site it is occurring also, only one lone pair electron can be contributed. So such type of ligands are called as what? Ambidentate ligands. Homoleptic ligands, same kind of ligands surround the central metal atom. Here, this is a homoleptic ligand. If I have CrH2O taken 5 times, Cl2 plus 1. Here, this is called as heteroleptic ligands, because water is there, chlorine is there. Two different kinds of ligands. They are called as what? Heteroleptic ligands. So this is a very simple objective, but you have to come across the examples of monodentate, bidentate, bidentate ethylene diamine and oxalate. These are all what? Bidentate ligands. And what is a polydentate ligand? Among them, which is chelating ligand? Among them, which is a bridge ligand? Like that, the questions may ask very rarely, but this is one first kind of objective coming from the first concept of coordination chemistry. Next important concept is how to find out effective atomic number. By finding effective atomic number, you will come to know whether the complex is stable or not. So this is very important objective. Please note it. First is examples on different types of ligands that you can refer any book. So for that you need not to take any notes. But this you take, how to calculate effective atomic number. What is effective atomic number? How to calculate? Chelate ligands, oxime, yeah, it can form, yes. Oxime is NOH. We can't say it is chelating ligand. We can say this is ambidentate ligand, Mayuri. Because from nitrogen or oxygen, only the bond can take place. From both the sides, central metal atom cannot take place. That is the difference between chelating and ambidentate ligand. Got the Mayuri? Got the answer? Understand? Chelating means definitely whatever sites are there, they are donating the electrons. Ambidentate means, ambidentate also like chelating, we are having different sites. More than one site only will be there. Already I told you, for example, oxime NOH, if you say nitrogen is there, oxygen is there. But while combining, either it may come from nitrogen or from oxygen. It cannot form a chelate ligand. All the time it necessarily need not to be formed chelating ligand. Got it? Ambidentate means, though it is having two different sides, the coordination comes only from one side. Chelating means how many sides are there, from all the corners the coordination complex will be taking place. That is the difference between ambidentate and chelating ligand. Hope you got it. Next, when a complex is given to you, whether it is stable or not, you will come to know by calculating effective atomic number. So how to calculate effective atomic number? Take the formula. atomic number of central metal atom. CMA means what? Central metal atom. Anything we are calculating or we are studying central metal atom or the complex, we are no way concerned with ionization sphere. So here atomic number of central metal atom minus oxidation state plus 2 into number of ligands. This is the formula to calculate effective atomic number. I'll give one example. K4FeCN taken 6 times. This hope everyone knows how to calculate oxidation state. So it is coming as what? FeCN taken 6 times minus 4. Let X is iron oxidation state plus 6 into cyanide is minus 1 is equals to minus 4. X is equal to 2. So oxidation state of iron is 2. Hope everyone know this how to calculate. First one example only I have shown you. Whoever don't know they can answer it. Now for this I want to calculate effective atomic number. Iron, central metal atom is iron. Atomic number is 26 minus 2 plus 2 into number of ligands. Ligands are 6. So 26 minus 2 plus 12 is equals to how much? 36. 36 is configuration, atomic number of krypton. If effective number is like effective atomic number is coming nearer to the inert gas elements, that complexes are more stable. If it is 34, 35 also stability will be there, but which is exactly will be having more stability which are going for nearly. If it is 31, 32, not much stable. So from this you can identify whether the stability of the complex is present at a certain level or not. You get the point? So this is how to calculate effective atomic number. Hope everyone got it. Then you people do for this effective atomic number. Calculate effective atomic number for this. Tell me the answer. Once more, effective atomic number is atomic number of central metal atom, iron 26, oxidation state 2, so minus 2 plus 2 into number of ligands, 2 into 6, 12. So how much I got? 36. That is effective atomic number. If effective atomic number is reaching nearest inert gas configuration, that is more stable. So for that we will see effective atomic number. But the answer for this effective atomic number, no answers this much time, you can complete in half minute. See how to calculate for this complex. Effective atomic number, here chromium oxidation state is 3, Cl, this is minus 2, minus 2 means this will become plus 2, that if it goes plus 3, chromium 24 minus 3 plus 2 into 5 plus 1, 6, 6 number of ligands, 24 minus 3 plus 12, so how much? 33, this is the effective atomic number. No one got it. Do for one more example, effective atomic number. NiCN taken 6 times minus 2. Make it fast. Calculate effective atomic number. Water 5 and chlorine 1, totally 6. Vignesh, got it? 5 plus 1, 6. 5 aqua ligands are there, 1 chloro ligand is there, that's why 6. For this, any answer? Anyone? Maybe. I'll see. I'll calculate. Okay. Nickel is 28. Oxidation state is plus 2. I'm very sorry. Cn taken 4 times you do. Then only you'll get plus 2. Extremely sorry. Maybe 36 you are getting. 36 or 38. Okay. I'll see. 28 minus 2 plus 2 into 4 is 8. So how much you are going to get? 32. In the case if you are taking 6, okay, that is correct only. Ni plus 4 you are substituting, now you are going to get 36. I made it as Cn 4. 4 means nickel is plus 2. 28 minus 2 plus 2 into 4, 8. So how much you are going to get? 8, 28, 22 only you are going to get. 28 plus 6, 34. 34 is the answer for this. 36 is correct only. In the previous case, I have given Cn taken 6 times, na? No issue. So, this is how to calculate effective atomic number. Okay. Now, this is one kind of very important objective. Please do practice whenever whatever complex you will come across, how to calculate effective atomic number. Next objective is theory based on Werner theory. So, based on that also some conceptual objectives are there. Let us see how to do objective on Werner theory. Everyone knows maybe Werner theory, but over that how we are going to get the objective, let us see. According to Werner theory, I will take one example, CrH2O taken 6 times Cl3. I have taken this. This is one complex. Chromium oxidation state is 3 here. Okay, so what is according to Werner theory? According to Werner theory, any complex will have two spheres. One is ionization sphere, the other one is coordination sphere. Ionization sphere is ionizable. So, here how many ions you are going to get? 3Cl minus and CrH2O taken 6 times minus 3. This is the splitting. So, totally how many ions you got it? 3 chloride ions and 1 complex ion, totally 4. This is one kind of objective. In a complex, how many number of ions will be produced? That is one kind of objective. If I have given like this, K4FeCn taken 6 times, tell me how many number of ions will be produced? From K4FeCn taken 6 times, how many number of ions will be produced? When you are dissolving in water, how many number of ions will be produced? Let me know. Make it fast. 5. Good. Because 4K plus and the another one is one complex ion. Cn6 minus 4. So, totally 4 and 1, 5 ions will be produced. That is one kind of objective. Next is, already you know, the primary valency, the central metal ion will have, here chromium is central metal ion. We are having two valencies. One is primary valency, second one is what? Secondary valency. What is primary valency? What is secondary valency also can be asked. Primary valency is nothing but what? Oxidation state that will be satisfied by ionization sphere. So, the oxidation state of chromium here, 3, calculate that itself is primary valency. Secondary valency is nothing but what? Coordination number. Here, what is the coordination number? 6. So, this is another kind of objective from Werner theory. What is primary valency? What is secondary valency? This you might be knowing. Primary valency is nothing but oxidation state. In this case, chromium oxidation state is 3. Secondary valency is nothing but what? Coordination number. That is 6. This is simple. This also you might be knowing. Got it? The next important objective like this, you see, I am giving two complexes, take the question, in which the complex you are going to get white precipitate when treated with AgNO3, take the question, in which complex you are going to get white precipitate by treating with AgNO3. If you add silver nitrate to which complex among these two, you are going to get white precipitate. So which complex you are going to get? Make it fast. Option 1 or 2? In this case, option 1 or 2. In which case you are going to, by seeing only you should answer. Yes, option 2, up there, wrong, option 1. Why? Because white precipitate means AgCl. This only can give. AgBr is which precipitate? Yellow precipitate. That is one kind of objective, isn't it? Or Tanisha, you also. Next. Another kind of question. I am giving options, you see. 1. CrH2O taken 5 times, ClCl2. Option 2. CrH2O taken 4 times, Cl2Cl. Option 3. CrH2O taken 6 times, Cl3. Option D. CrH2O taken 3 times, Cl3. Among them, which will react with 1 mole of AgNO3? Which complex will react with only 1 mole of AgNO3? I am asking. Got it? Which complex will react with 1 mole of AgNO3 among these 4 options? Which option? 1, 2, 3, 4 I have given. Which option you are going to get? Second option. Correct. Okay, this is very simple objective on Werner theory. Because, no, one, option 2, yes, correct, option 2 is correct answer. Why? Because here 2 chlorines means it can react with 2 moles of AgNO3. Here only 1 mole. Here 3. In this case, there is no precipitate. Whatever chloride ions are there inside the coordination sphere cannot be come out to react with AgNO3. So, these are the different kinds of questions you are coming across Werner theory. So, this will be an easy concept. I hope no one will be doing mistake over this. Okay. So, this is one kind of objective. Next important objective is nomenclature. Nomenclature is known. Simple complex you might be knowing. Let me tell you some complex compounds if they are giving, how to write, I'll tell you. First, let us discuss some rules. Everybody might be knowing, but let me tell you one time. I have taken a complex like this, you see. CrH2O taken 5 times, ClCl2. This is the complex K4FeCn taken 6 times, 2 complexes. Generally, IUPAC convention is cation followed anion. This is IUPAC convention. So, first should be always electropositive. Next should be always electronegative. This is applicable to whole inorganic chemistry. So, in this case, if you observe, actually 2Cl minus, this will become plus 2. K4 means minus 4. This is plus 1. This is minus 1. In the first example, the coordination sphere is acting as cation. In the second one, the coordination sphere is acting as anion. So, first cation should be done, then anion, already I told you. Now, we have to describe coordination sphere first and then only ionization sphere. In this case, first ionization sphere, then only coordination sphere describing. So, here let us see, first I am seeing cation. What is cation? Potassium. So, potassium. Now, describing complex. In complex, first what you have to describe? Ligands. How many are there? If it is a monodentate ligand, di, bi, di, tri, likewise you can take. Here 6, hexa, cyano, CN means cyano, ferrate. What is the oxidation state here? 2. Ferrate 2. This is the name. If central metal atom is in anionic sphere, it should end as what? 8. Ferrate followed with its oxidation state in Roman numbers. Come to here. First we have to describe this. In this case you should not write chromate, chromium. If it is cation, then you have to end the central metal atom as chromium. Ferrum, likewise only, but you should not end with 8. Here we are having two ligands. What are they? Water and chlorine. Alphabetical order. What is aqua amino, isn't it? So this is aqua means A. First we have to spell this, then only this one. So what you are going to get? Penta aqua chloro chromium 3 chloride. So if central metal atom is coming in anionic sphere, you can end it as 8. If it is coming in cationic sphere, it should be read it is like metal species only. So this is the first rule. Hope everyone might be knowing this. Okay. Now take the another example I am going to tell you. This is given to you. COEN taken twice, Cl, Cl2. Cl2, Cl I'll take. Yes, Cl2, Cl. This rule I want to tell you, listen. Can anyone name this? This is EN is ethylene diamine, a bidentate ligand. Bidentate ligand should be repeated with what? Bis, tris. Monodentate means di, tri, hexa, likewise. Bidentate means bis, tris, like that you have to spell. Now this is cationic sphere, cobalt is 3. So how to name this? Dichloro, here chloro comes first, alphabetical order. Ethylene, diamine, next. So what is the name for is dichloro bis, because this is bidentate. Ethylene, diamine, cobalt, 3 chloride. So this is the name for this. So if bidentate ligands comes bis, tris, for oxalate also bis, tris, like that you have to use. It should not use di, tri, such kind of terminology for this. Copy it. One example I am showing, one kind of rule. Hope everyone copied this. If you have any doubt, you can post till here. Next. Till here we have seen only one coordination sphere. I will give you one example, you see how this is going to be. PT NH3 taken twice Cl2, PT Cl4. How to name this? EN is oxalato, no Mayuri, ethylene diamine. Oxalato means C2O4 will come. EN means ethylene diamine, oxalato means C2O4 minus 2 will come. Okay. Or else OXO, OX also they will represent sometime, that is oxalato. Okay. Next. Can you answer this? Here we are having cationic sphere coordination, anionic sphere also coordination. So for this, how to give the numbering, let us see. So any doubts, something is typing. So let us see first this, how to name this one. Here how to find the oxidation state, first let us see. For this complex you see, ammonia is 0, neutral ligand. Cl is minus 2 because 2 chlorine. So this should be how much? Plus 2. The total charge of this should be plus 2. Here this is minus 4, this should be how much? Plus 4, that is inside the complex. And this plus 4 should be satisfied, this platinum, and this plus 2 should be satisfied, this platinum. So here the oxidation state of platinum is how much? 4. Here the oxidation state of platinum is how much? 2. So this is how to give the oxidation states for the elements. Whatever, diamine, dichloroplatinum, tetrachloroplatinum. Oh, you are giving the answer. Abhishek, for this. Platinum you should not say. I'll take up to some part correct only. But you have missed platinate too, you have to write, Abhishek. Good, up to some part you have done correct. So for this, how to give the name is, Hope you all understand how to give the oxidation states. Here oxidation state comes to be 4 for platinum, that should be satisfied this complex. Here it is coming to be 2, that should be satisfied by this complex. So here the oxidation state of platinum is 4, here the oxidation state of platinum is 2. So here how to clarify, like how to give the name, first we have to describe this. So diamine, dichloro, platinum 4. So cation we have described. Now anion, tetra chloro platinate you have to say. We have to end anion with platinate. So this is platinate, sorry, 2. Platinate 2. Platinate is in anionic sphere. That should be end with what? 8. That's why you have to write it as what? Platinate 2. Got it? This is how to name if both cation and anion are given as complexes. I'll give one more similar type. You take this one. For this, tell the name. NH3. Is that amino? Amine, diamine. Amino, when it will come? Finish? Do this one. Do that example. I'll see one more example for you. Diamine only we have to say, not amino. Okay, Mayuri asked. I didn't understand what Abhishek posted there. Amino means NH2 minus ma. Here NH3 means amine only we have to say. Okay. Can you trace this one? How to do? See here, how to give the oxidation states. Here ammonia is a neutral ligand. Here C2O4 is oxalate. Oxalate means minus 2. Totally charge is 6. So this 6 charge should be balanced by that and this. So this chromium should be plus 3. This cobalt should be plus 3. Then totally plus 6 and it will be balanced by minus 6. So what is the oxidation state of each element? Plus 3, plus 3. So identifying the oxidation state is only important, the everything you can do. Total charge for this complex is minus 3 plus into 2, minus 2 into 3 is minus 6. That should be balanced by these two means, this should be plus 3, this should be plus 3. So what you are going to get? Hexaamine chromium 3. This is next come to anion. Tris, because this is bidentate, oxalato cobaltate 3. This is the name of the complex. Got it? So this is how to give the nomenclature for complex cation and anion together comes. Okay, this is one kind of objective. Next important objective is from isomerism. So let us see isomerism. In isomerism also we are having structural as well as stereoisomerism. Remember, first we are going to see structural isomerism. Along with me, take the examples. See, the first example I am giving, take this one, CrH2O taken 5 times ClBr. Another example is CrH2O taken 5 times BrCl. What is the difference between yes, oxalato? C2O4 is oxalate. So, oxalato ion. C2O4 is oxalate ion, no? Oxalate is a bidentate ligand. From carbon corner you can get, from oxygen corner also. 2 oxygen, C. Oxalic acid is what? COOH, COOH. This is called as oxalato ion. So, from this oxygen, from this oxygen, 2 sides are there. That's why it is called as oxalato. Okay. Within? Yeah. This is called as what? C2O4 minus 2. It is a bidentate ligand. So, 2 into 3 is equals to minus 6. That should be balanced by both the metal atoms. So, that we have done. Okay. Mayuri, you understand, even Harita. This is oxalato means oxalic acid. We have removed 2 hydrogens, that is oxalato ion. Yes, this is correct. Ionization isomerism. Because in ionization chamber, it is bromine. In ionization chamber, it gives chloride ion. And if you see, both are having same molecular formula. So, this isomerism is called as what? Ionization isomerism. Okay. Next. See this example. And what you are going to say, you see. CO, H2O taken 5 times, Cl, Cl. CO, H2O taken 4 times, Cl to H2O. What is the difference between this and this? Which isomerism we can have? This one. What is this isomerism? Any answer? This is called as hydrated isomerism. Hydration isomerism. So, what is hydration isomerism? Here, water molecule, from 5 water molecules, the coordinate covalent bond is formed with cobalt. Here in this case, how many water molecules are giving? Only 4. Yeah, that kind of isomerism is called as what? Hydrated isomerism or hydration isomerism. Okay. Next, take this one. NiCl3CN plus 2, sorry, minus 2. NiCl3NC minus 2. What is the difference between this and this? In this case and in this case, what is the difference? Already I told you, CN and NC are ambidentate ligands. Both are having donating sites, but from which it is coming is only important there. These 2 are examples for linkage isomerism. So, what is linkage isomerism? In this case, for nickel, 3 chloride ions they are giving. From this, C is donating nickel. From in this, N is donating lone pair electrons to nickel. So, such type of isomerism is called as what? Linkage isomerism. Got it? What? Amphidentate, not amphi, ambidentate. Okay. Amphi also you can say. These are ambidentate ligands only. But which kind of isomerism they are undergoing, I asked. Linkage isomerism. So, from which link the central metal atom is getting electrons? So, such type of isomerism is called as what? Linkage isomerism. Take this example. CrNH3 taken 6 times, COCN taken 6 times. CrCN taken 6 times, CONH3 taken 6 times. What is the difference between these 2? Which type of isomerism is this? Coordination isomerism, correct. In coordination sphere, there is exchange of ligands. So, that type of isomerism is called as what? A coordination isomerism. So from here the question, two isomerisms, they belongs to which kind of isomerism, or this will be undergone, or coordination isomerism will be shown by these complexes, such kind of objective you are going to come across. Do you get the point? So this is simple objective, go through the examples and identify which isomerism they are exhibiting. Okay. Next, one simple concept I want to tell you, these complexes can exhibit even optical isomerism also. Remember certain point, one point, so that it can helpful to you for your objective. Optical isomerism I am saying, even geometrical, they can exhibit to geometrical and optical isomerism also. Few, not all complexes, few complexes only can exhibit. Who can exhibit geometrical is square planar and octahedral complexes. Only these can exhibit cis-and-trans. In geometrical, cis-and-trans, EZ, anything, they can be exhibited only by these two, square planar and octahedral only can exhibit geometrical isomerism, cis-trans isomerism. Optical can be exhibited by tetrahedral, octahedral. So what I'll say is, if any objective comes from this particular concept, octahedral means don't have any problem. Coordination number should be 6, they can exhibit geometrical as well as this, but not all forms, only few forms. For square planar and tetrahedral, for example, I have given to you NiCl4-2, NiCn6-2. Actually, NiCl4-2 is a tetrahedral complex. This is square planar. Anyway, from valence bond theory, we will come to know which is tetrahedral, which is square planar. Next concept is that. Even you also might have done. So among these two, which can exhibit optical isomerism means what you have to opt this answer. So see to the examples. If they ask which is exhibiting cis-trans means, search the formula which is going for square planar structure. Valence bond theory you can apply and collect whether it is square planar or tetrahedral. Square planar can undergo cis-trans, tetrahedral can undergo optical, that you remember. You get the point. And you can opt accordingly. So this is minimum knowledge if you possess. If objective comes from this particular part, you can have it. Did you understand this one? Octahedral means no problem, whether it is DSP2 or SP2D, anything, I mean like D2 SP3 or SP3D2 also, definitely they will undergo geometrical as well as optical. In that also certain forms are there, but keep this knowledge, up to some extent it will be useful to you. You get the point? Any doubt in this particular point? You understand? Please note it. Now let us see valence bond theory. That is only our major concept. Valence bond theory and molecular orbital theory. From these two concepts, 90% of objective concentration is from that particular concepts. This knowledge, if you have, it will be useful to you. Werner theory couldn't explain the geometry of the complexes. Now our main study is complex study only, na? So the geometry, shape, magnetic behavior, colored, colorless, everything is explained through VBT only. So this only explained this complex. So with the help of example, let us, I'll take one example and I'll tell you. Now please take the series, spectrochemical series you take, because you should come to know which is strong ligand and which is weak ligand. So note this spectrochemical series. I minus less than Br minus less than Cl minus less than F minus. Here comes OH, then only F minus. Take the series F minus C2O4-2 less than water less than CNS thiocyanate less than ammonia less than EN less than, correct, NO2 minus less than CN minus less than CO. This is spectrochemical series. If you remember this, you will come to know which is strong and which is weak. Underline H2O2, this particular concept. This I will tell you, exceptional case. These are all weak ligands. These are all strong ligands. Strong ligands, weak ligands. You should know, no, which is weak ligand, which is strong ligand. Then only you can do pairing and unpairing. By knowing already charge I have given, you can substitute the charge for oxidation state. If you have any doubt, what is the charge for this? Here I have given the charge. Ammonia, ethylene, diamine, water are only neutral. The rest of all are possessing one or two charges, minus. So through this, cobalt also, zero. Carbonyl group, CO, not cobalt. CO is carbonyl group is also zero. Okay. Now let us take one example. I will tell you how to work out. An example is given to you like this. See, CrH2O taken 6 times plus 3. For this complex, how to, various questions, hybridization, shape, the paramagnetic or diamagnetic, colored or colorless, everything you can come to know along with valence bond theory. How to do, let us see. Here, what is the central metal ion? Chromium. This is 0, H2O. So, definitely chromium oxidation state is plus 3. So, basically chromium configuration is 4s2 3d4. So, Cr plus 3 means 4s0 3d3. So, 3 electrons are there in 3d. This is 4s. This is 4p. 3d, 4s, 4p, and you can go for 4d. If necessary, you can use 4d orbitals. Okay. How many electrons are there? 3. 1, 2, 3. Water is ready to do 6 lone pair, means it needs 6 vacant orbitals. Anyway, these are free. It can use 2d orbitals, 1 4s and 3p. So, what is the hybridization? D2sp3. Whether hybridization D2sp3 or sp3D2, what is the shape? Octahedral. Shape is octahedral. Unpaired electrons are there. If all are paired, diamagnetic. Unpaired electrons are there. This is which in nature? Paramagnetic. Magnetic moment, root N into N plus 2 Bohr magneton. N into N plus 2 means root 3 into 3 plus 2. If definitely paramagnetic means unpaired electrons, in the same way colored. So, these are the various kinds of questions. A complex will be given to you, which hybridization, shape, paramagnetic or diamagnetic, what is the magnetic moment or the colored or colorless, or else 4 complexes will be given to you, which is undergoing D2sp3 hybridization, or which is having more paramagnetic nature, which is having poor paramagnetic nature means more number of unpaired electrons, more will be the paramagnetic nature. I don't get you, ma'am, Cr plus 3. Harita, don't you know how to find out oxidation state? Water is 0. So, nothing. So, chromium oxidation state totally goes to chromium plus 3. Okay? Chromium 4s2 3d4. 3 electrons are to be removed. 4s0 3d3. Got, Harita? So, that is how to calculate the oxidation states. So, these are the various kinds of questions comes from valence bond theory. I will tell you, first let us see the normal theory, exceptional cases also there. That is also very important concept we have to learn. Hope everyone copied this. We have seen octahedral now, we will see one tetrahedral and square planar. Then I will tell the real concept of VBT where exceptional cases are to be considered. So all these theories now, according to their behavior we have framed the theory. According to our theory, they are not going. Okay. So, in exceptional cases, what are the reasons we are going to give? We will see for the further examples. Now, I will take one example for square planar. Take this complex. NiCN taken 4 times minus 2 I have given. Harita, listen how to calculate oxidation state. Nickel oxidation state is X, let it be, don't know. 4 into Cn oxidation state minus 1. This charge you can use for oxidation state, I told, is equals to minus 2. X is equals to how much? Plus 2. Nickel is bearing plus 2 oxidation state. Basically, nickel configuration is 4s2 3d8. Ni plus 2 means 4s0 3d8. This is the configuration. Now write 3d. So, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4s and p, 4p. First, basically 8 electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is basic configuration. Will they ask what color? No, no. That is also there, Abhishek. They'll ask. I'll tell you. That is the last concept in molecular orbital theory will come across. I'll tell that is there. Definitely they'll ask what is the color. But that we are not explaining through VBT. That we are explaining only through molecular orbital theory. Okay? Next. How to conform D2 SP3 or SPT D2? That's what I'm telling you, Shweta. In the previous case, water is a weak ligand, so pairing cannot take place. Now here I'll show you. Wait. Got it? This is Cn. Cn is a strong ligand. If Cn is a strong ligand, the pairing will take place. Here two unpaired electrons are there, but they will be arranging like pairing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This orbital is vacant. Got it? And it need how many orbitals? 4. So 1d orbital, inner orbital it can use. And here 1s. Here 3p it can use. So what it will be the, it, actually it is 4 orbitals it need. So it can use dsp2 hybridization. Cn is strong ligand. So pairing takes place. In the previous case, water is a weak ligand. We cannot pair up and we will not use. Anyway, 2d orbitals already we got it now. So, we have used inner orbitals. If in this case, actually d orbitals are not vacant. As Cn is strong ligand, pairing has taken place and one orbital is vacant. So, now we can use inner orbitals. So, what is the hybridization? dsp2. dsp2 means, what is the structure? Square planar. dsp2 means what is the shape? Square planar. Is it paramagnetic or diamagnetic? Dia, because all are paired. So diamagnetic and colorless. If unpaired electrons are there, then only paramagnetic and colored. Here all are paired, diamagnetic and colorless. So I have shown you the example for square planar. Please copy along with me. Okay. Now let us see one more example for tetrahedral. This spectrochemical series please do remember. Then you will come to know which is strong ligand, which is weak ligand. I am taking NiCl4 taken minus 2. Cl is a weak ligand. In the previous case Cn is a strong ligand. Now Cl is becoming weak ligand. So, here nickel oxidation state is plus 2. Previous case you have seen configuration is 4s0 3d8. So, write 3d 4s 4p. Try to write like this. Don't draw orbitals and all. Time waste. D will be having 5 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. S1. P how many are there? 3. Here 5 places now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But Cl is a weak ligand. Pairing cannot take place. But how many orbitals it need? 4. It can use only this. So what will be the hybridization? sp3. sp3 means tetrahedral. Cl is a weak ligand. We cannot pair up. Okay. Need tetrahedral for dsp2. dsp2 means square planar. sp3d means tetrahedral. Got it? So, here two unpaired electrons are there. This is which in nature? Paramagnetic. So, colored. So, depends upon the ligand. You have to see whether we have to do pairing or non-pairing. Did you get the point? So already I told you, these are all weak ligands. Not underlined one, I am not saying. Before underlined one, before water all weak ligands. These are all what? Strong ligands. If weak ligands are there, pairing cannot take place. If strong ligands are there, pairing can take place. One more thing I want to tell you. Actually, inner complex, outer complex, sometimes you will come across this terminology, high spin, low spin. Actually, that terminology comes with LFT. But when you are doing valence bond theory also, you can identify. If it is weak ligand, note this point. If it is weak ligand, definitely it will be outer spin complex. Outer complex or high spin complex. Anything you can say. Outer complex or high spin complex. Sometimes you will come across this terminology also. If it is strong ligand, inner complex or low spin complex. I'll tell you why they got the name. That comes, this terminology actually comes with molecular orbital theory. But sometimes by doing valence bond theory also, we can opt that one directly. You need not to go for LFT. Okay. LFT you use whenever they are asking to calculate energy. Or else do this and apply directly over this objective. Okay. So dsp3 will not be there, Mayuri. Dsp2 will be there, or else sp3 will be there. DSP3 means it, you are not going to get a square planar or tetrahedral. Maybe posting error there. Hope you all understand. See, I have shown the normal case. Based on our theory, strong ligands can pair, weak ligands cannot pair. But I have underlined H2O, CNS and NH3, isn't it? These in general they will say weak ligands. But in certain cases they can act as strong ligands also. So, I will show you one example where it is acting as strong ligand. In which case you have to consider it as strong ligand. I am dusting this. Be careful. These are all exceptional cases. I am taking an example like this. See here. CONH3 taken 6 times plus 3. In this case, ammonia should be actually weak ligand. Why it is acting as a strong ligand? Let us see. Cobalt oxidation state is plus 3 only, na? Ammonia is 0. Basically, 4s2, 3d7. Now the electrons are converting as what? 3d6. Cobalt plus 3 means 3d6. If electrons are d6, d7, d8, d9 after removing electrons, in this case, ammonia, water can act as strong ligands. Remember this point. If D6, D7, D8, D9. This is experimental study. This is not an hypothetical theory. Experimental study has done. If these electrons are there after removing, not before removing, then they can act as what? Strong ligands. This rule also violated. One more case is there. I will show the next concept. Yes, DSP2 hybridization. Last Cl I have given. Ma. Cl means sp3. Because chlorine cannot pair up, no? So that's why sp3. Cn means pairing takes place. That's why DSP2 Mayuri. And the next case what I have given is Cl. Ligands I have changed. sp3 last case. Now listen to this complex. Please concentrate on this exceptional case. When ammonia and water can act as strong ligands, basically weak ligands, when they will be acting as strong ligand means after removal of electrons, if you are having D6, D7, D8, D9, they can act as strong ligands. There is a scope. So D6 means this is 3D, 4S, 4P, 4D. Any orbitals they can use. In D, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, S1, P3, the next. 6 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. D6, no? But in this case, what I said, ammonia is a strong ligand acting because D6 electrons. So, the configuration changes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2 vacant orbitals are free, sp are free. So, it is using these orbitals and it is undergoing which hybridization? D2 sp3 means what is the shape? Octahedral. In octahedral only I told you, both are octahedral, but few are low spin, few are high spin. Now ammonia is acting as a strong. Strong means which one? Low spin complex this is. This is low spin complex or inner complex, anything you can term. So this is exceptional case. In general we will study ammonia as a weak ligand, but in this case what happened? Ammonia is acting as a strong ligand. So what I told you is D6, D7, D8, D9 electrons, in that case they can act as strong ligands. Copied this one. I will show the another case where this rule is violating. This rule will be violating. Why it is violating? Let us see. So it is not in certain cases also. If D7 electrons are there also, it is not working. Why? Let us see. Hope you all have copied this. Now I am taking another complex where this rule gets violated, and why it is violating, let us give explanation. I have taken a complex like this, CrH2O taken 6 times plus 2. So here what is the oxidation state? Cobalt plus 2. Basically configuration 4s2 3d7. 2 electrons gone means 3d7. 3d7 means water should act as strong ligand. So pairing should takes place. So what is happening? Let us see. 3d. So how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4s. 4p. 1, 2, 3. And then 4d. If necessary, use this orbitals. 3d7 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are all free. 3 unpaired electrons are there. If H2O is strong, actually what should happen? This should get paired. So if it is getting paired, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 orbital is left over. So it has to use only one inner d orbital. How many it needs? 6. In this case, it has to use one 3d, one s, 3p, one more d. This d is from inner, this d is from outer. We don't have such hybridization, no? We don't have dsp3d, we don't have. Either 2d orbitals should come from 3d or 2d orbitals should come from 4d. We cannot take one 3d and one 4d. Why? Because hybridization involves the intermixing of equal or nearly equal energy, but not a difference in the high energy. We can combine 3d, 4s, 4p or 4s, 4p, 4d. They are set of equivalent energies or nearly equal, but 3d and 4d are very different in their energy levels. They cannot intermix. So in this case, water is having capability of pairing, but there is of no use. If it is vacating 2, it can use d. After pairing also only one orbital is left over. In that case, anyway it has to go for 4d orbitals utilization. So in this case the pairing will not take place. So it is using which orbitals? Outer. So you are going to get the which configuration? sp3d2 only. This molecule is paramagnetic. sp3d2 is octahedral. But using outer orbitals, so high spin complex. Outer orbital complex. Hope you understand, you catch the point. Okay. See, if it is having capacity to pair up also, it is no scope of vacating 2 vacant orbitals. It need 2 vacant orbitals for d2sp3. But we don't have that many d vacant orbitals even though pairing. That's why instead of pairing, it is using which orbitals? 4d orbitals. 3d orbital cannot combine with 4d to give the hybrid orbital. So this is an exceptional case in this case. Like this. In general, our valence bond theory is applicable 95%, but 5% exceptional cases are also there. In such a case, you have to learn in such a way. You get the point? So, any doubt till here? If not, I'll go for molecular orbital theory. Any doubt in this valence bond theory concept? No, I hope. Then I'll go for valence bond theory. Okay? Sorry, molecular orbital theory. or LFT. Valence bond theory successfully explained the hybridization, the shape, paramagnetic, diamagnetic, what colored or colorless, everything. But stabilization of complex depends upon the stabilization energy. That could not be explained through VBT. To explain the stability of complex, then the next theory has come is LFT. Previously, LFT and a molecular orbital are different, but at present we are merging and we are studying as what? Same, ligand field theory or molecular orbital theory. What is ligand field theory or molecular orbital theory? Listen, in valence bond theory, metal and ligand are connected by dative bond, coordinate covalent bond. Got it? That's why it is called as what? Coordinate covalent bond. So, according to valence bond theory, there is a dative bond between metal and ligand. Now, come to LFT, ligand field theory. What ligand field theory states that the bond between them is purely ionic. That concept started with LFT. LFT concept is ionic bond formation. VBT concept is molecular orbital concept. So, what is this actually? Actually, metal is a positively charged ion, ligand is negatively charged species. According to molecular orbital theory, definitely there is an electrostatic force of attraction between them. So, they are forming what bond? Ionic bond. So, it is not covalent bond. They have considered it as what? Ionic bond. Okay. While forming ionic bond, these are negatively charged species. Electrons will be there, electron rich species. In metal also, in d orbital, some electrons will be there. So, repulsions will be there between electrons of metal and electrons of ligand. They are having repulsions between them. That is the main cause for MO theory and the stabilization of the molecule. So, they have considered the point which they have concentrated, the repulsions between the ligands and the electrons present in the metal ion. That is the basic theory started with LFT. So, repulsions, what is doing? In metal, we are having d orbitals. Electrons will be present in which orbitals? D, we know. So, how many d orbitals are there? 5. What are they? Dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus y square, dz square. So, these are degenerate orbitals. At ground state, all these are having same energy level. But when ligand comes, repulsions, because of repulsions, these energy levels are splitting into two category. One is Eg, the another one is 2Tg, T2G. I told no? When ligand is approaching metal ion, repulsions will be there between inner electrons of metal and electrons on ligand. That repulsions are increasing energy and these energies are, levels are splitted into two category. What is they? One is Eg, the another one is what? T2G. Eg comes dx square minus y square dz square. T2g r dxy dyz dzx. They may be lowered in energy, they may be higher in energy to their normal state. But in octahedral only, I am saying you have only octahedral. Our NCRT portion is octahedral. Okay, tetrahedral is different, square planar is different. We are learning octahedral. In octahedral complex, T2g orbitals are lowered by 0.6 units. 0.6 minus 0.6 means lowered by 0.6 units, it means to say. Eg are increased by 0.4 units. This is Eg and this is T2g. In Eg, how many are there? 2. In T2g, how many are there? 3. So, in octahedral only, because of the ligands in their positions, the T2G are lowering by 0.6 units and Eg is increasing by 0.4 units. So, after splitting the orbitals, we have to fill the electrons. For example, if I am having 7 electrons, D7, if the ligand is strong, in the previous case we have seen D6 electrons, this in the previous case you have seen, no, CrNH3 taken 6 times plus 3. Previous example only. Here D6, And ammonia is acting as which ligand? Strong ligand. How to fill in the strong ligand? Strong ligand means here T2G, EG. Strong ligand means first 1, 2, 3. Strong, no? Pairing here only takes place. 4, 5, 6. EG will not go. That's why low spin I said, na? Low spin means what? Strong ligand is low spin because every electron is going into the lower orbitals only. In the next case I told you, see, CrH2O taken 6 times plus 2. Here H2O is acting as a weak ligand in the previous case only. In this case how many electrons are there? D7 plus 2, D7, not chromium, cobalt. Okay. In the previous case only we have done D7. D7 means it is a weak ligand. In weak ligand how to fill? 1, 2, 3. Weak, no? EG will occupy 4, 5. Then only pairing starts 6, 7. You get the point? So this is how the electrons are entering into T2G and EG. There is a lot of difference. Strong ligand means pairing takes place in T2G. Then only electrons enters into EG. It is a weak ligand, 1-1 electron in T2G, EG, again pairing starts in what? T2G. This is how the electrons enters after the splitting. From this you can calculate delta O, CFSE energy, crystal field stabilization energy, CFSE is represented by delta O. Delta O means for octahedral only. Number of electrons in T2G, their energy, plus number of electrons in EG. This is the formula you have to use. In this case, T2G, how many are there? 6. So, 6 into, what is the energy for T2G? Minus 0.6. So, how much you are going to get? Minus 1.8. In this case, this is the answer. In this case, delta O is equals to, how many are there? 5. 5 into minus 0.6 plus 2 into 0.4. So, 3.0 minus 3.0 plus 0.8. So, how much you are going to get? Minus 2.2. This is the answer in this case. So, this is crystal field stabilization energy, how to calculate. This is very important objective in NEET. Hope you all understand this. Again, I am explaining. Please do listen. According to LFT, the bond between metal and ligand is ionic bond. They didn't consider it as coordinate covalent bond. They have considered it as what? Ionic bond. So attraction will be there between positive ion and the ligand. Later what is happening? Repulsions are starting between inner electrons of D and electrons on ligand. So they are increasing the energy levels of the orbitals. Because of that, the degenerate orbitals which should be having same energy, they have splitted into this. Two, what are they? EG, T2G. EG are having what? DX square minus Y square, DZ square. T2G are having what? DXY, DYZ and DX. In octahedral alone I am saying. In octahedral, T2G orbitals are lowered by how many units? 0.6 units. EG will be increased by 0.4 units. That is the concept of octahedral. Now when an octahedral complex is given to you, how to calculate CFSC, crystal field stabilization energy or splitting energy, how to calculate? First take electrons in this complex. How many electrons are there? 6 d electrons after removal. Ammonia is which ligand? Strong ligand. If it is strong ligand, first electrons enters into T2G. Pairing also takes place. Then only they will enter into EG. So 6 means here it is filled. But in this complex you see water is a weak ligand. In the previous case only we have seen. In that case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then only 6 and 7. Pairing starts. Here all are filled with lower orbitals. That's why it is called as what? Low spin. In the previous case also I told you. Strong field means low spin. Inner orbitals. Weak ligand means high spin because they are going to high or outer. Outer orbitals are also occupied. So, here it has come as what? High spin. Then how to calculate CFSE? Number of electrons in T2G. How many number of electrons are there and their energy? Plus number of electrons in EG with their energy. So here only in T2G, no, 6 into minus 0.6, 1.8. In this case, 5 electrons in T2G and 2 electrons in EG. So this calculation. Hope everyone understand this. If you have any doubts in this particular concept, please post the question. This is a new theory, I believe. You have come across now itself. But many papers are there based on this, the questions. If you have any doubts, you ask and you just carry on this one. Any doubts? Shall I give you one example? Will you do whether it is low spin or high spin? Can you tell? And calculate CFSE value. Take this example. FeCn taken 6 times minus 4. Take this. With that knowledge you do. I am keeping it on the board. FeCn taken 6 times minus 4. Do for this. And tell me whether it is low spin, high spin. What is delta O for this? For this complex, what is delta O, you tell. Minus 3.6. Okay. Any other answers? Let us see and then I'll do. Meanwhile, Abhishek, you are asking regarding color of the complex. The weak ligands will absorb the energy of lower light. Lower light means high wavelength. They are absorbing energy of high wavelength. They can exhibit the corresponding color. Hope you understand. So in any reference book at the last, I think in CBSE textbook also, at the corner the light radiation will be given to you. So accordingly the color of the complex what they are exhibiting you can say. Got it? Which are absorbing lower wavelength, they will exhibit. Lower wavelength means what? Higher energy. So they can exhibit the color, the leftover color they are exhibiting. So accordingly you can answer that one, but very rare cases they are asking that. That particular concept is also there. Minus 3.6 only you got. Good. FeCn6 means what is the oxidation state of iron? Plus 2. Basically configuration is 4s2 3d6. Now we got the electron 3d6 we got it. Cn is which ligand? Strong ligand. Strong ligand means first they have to enter into T2G. So T2G, EG. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So delta O is equals to 6 into minus 0.6 minus 3.6. Okay? Good. Correct. Till here it is there in CBSE. If they ask for tetrahedral complex, square planar is a very complex, that is a different thing. It is out of portion and very complex study. Tetrahedral also not necessary for you, but if it is given, how to do, you see. Same concept. Hope everyone has done this. Finish. Simple For tetrahedral, na, this will become reverse. That is the only difference between this and that. I am just saying. In the previous case, I have shown only for octahedral. Now, let us see for tetrahedral if they have given how to calculate CFSE. For tetrahedral, reverse. Eg will be lowered by 0.4 units. Energy remains same. But Eg are lowering by 0.4 units. T2g are increasing by how much? 0.6 units. These are T2g. These are Eg for tetrahedral. Okay. In the previous case, I have given one example. NiCl4 minus 2. This is tetrahedral only, na? Sp3. Nickel plus 2. So, how many electrons? D8. So, how to fill first? Eg, T2g. Chlorine is a weak ligand. 8 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Strong means Eg will be filled. Then only they will enter into T2g. It is which complex? High spin complex. So, how to calculate delta T? Delta T means CFSE for tetrahedral. So, same. 4, 4 into minus 0.4 plus here how many electrons? 4, 4 into 0.6. Minus 1.6 plus 4, 2.4. So, how much you are going to get? 0.8. Huh? This is for delta T. This is tetrahedral. But square planar means you cannot apply these two. That is different. In square planar, dxy, dyz will be lowered. Then dz square. Then dzx. Then dx square minus y square. That splitting is quite complex when compared to these two. Because in square planar, four are in different and this here and there. Got it? Any doubt in this particular concept? Please work out objective based on this. Now, let us recollect inorganic chemistry. I have completed inorganic part, main part of inorganic chemistry lessons. Chemical bonding, periodic classification, coordination chemistry. Together you may be getting 5 to 6 objective. These are the main lessons you have to see. So, in coordination chemistry, come across the nomenclature, effective atomic number, isomerism, VBT and CFSE, LFT. Chemical bonding and periodic classification, already I told you how the questionnaires will come from that particular part. If you are well thorough with this, then you can go for S block and P block. From S block and P block, you may be getting 3 to 4 questions. From together, 3 to 4 or 5 questions you may be getting. So, then you can go, you can give the last priority for S and P. Later, if we are completing the weightage lessons, we will go for S and P. So, with this important weightage lessons in coordination means inorganic chemistry is completed. In the next class, we will see solid state. That is also physical chemistry, very important topic. Okay. So, in this particular part, if you are having any doubts, you can ask. So, what else? With this, we can wind up the coordination chemistry. If you have any doubt in LFT or VBT, you can ask. Any doubts? So, everyone understand. So, please practice over these important concepts.